forms definition. Let fx denotes any function of x of a prescribed class of function defined on a given interval ab. Let kxp denotes a definite function of x on this interval. For each value of p, a parameter, real or complex, independent of x, and whose domain is prescribed, then the linear integral transform tfxp of the function fx is defined by the integral equation tfxp is equal to integral a to b kxp fx dx, wherein the class of functions and domain of p are so prescribed that the integral in 1.1.1 converges absolutely. In this equation, kxp is known as the kernel of the transform tfxp. The image of fx in the said transform and fx the original of txp. Sectionally or piecewise continuous functions. Definition: let fx be a function defined in certain interval ab. Suppose that the interval ab can be subdivided into finite number of subintervals such that fx is continuous in each of these open subintervals, and at the end points of these subintervals the right hand and the left hand limits exist and finite, then fx is known as sectionally continuous or piecewise continuous function. Example: consider fx is equal to x square plus 1 for x lying between 1 and pi by 2, and fx is equal to sin x for x lying between pi by 2 to pi, and fx is equal to mod x if pi is less than equal to x is less than equal to 4. Here fx is sectionally continuous function in the closed interval 1 to 4. As the function is continuous in each of the open subintervals 1, pi by 2, pi by 2, pi and pi to 4, and has definite right hand and left hand limits at the end points x is equal to 1, pi by 2, pi and 4 of these subintervals. Functions of exponential order. Definition: a function fx is said to be of exponential order gamma. Gamma is greater than 0 as x tends to infinity if limit e raised to minus gamma x fx is equal to a finite quantity, or for a given number x naught there exists a real constant m greater than 0 such that mod e raised to minus gamma x fx is less than m for all x greater than equal to x naught, or mod fx should be less than m e raised to gamma x for all x greater than equal to x0, and we write it as fx is equal to of order e raised to gamma x as x tends to infinity, or equivalently limit x tending to infinity e raised to minus delta x mod fx is less than m limit x tending to infinity e raised to minus delta minus gamma x is equal to 0, delta is greater than gamma. Such a function fx is simply called an exponential order x, exponential order as x tends to infinity, and clearly it does not grow faster than m e raised to gamma x as x tending to infinity. Further, if delta is greater than gamma, then e raised to delta x is greater than e raised to gamma x, x is greater than 0, and so exponential order gamma implies exponential order delta. Thus, it is sufficient to take smallest value of gamma satisfying 1.5.1 is the exponential order of the function fx. Example, bounded functions such as sin ax, cos ax are of exponential order 0. Example, the function x square is of exponential order 3. Since limit x tending to infinity x square e raised to minus 3x is equal to limit x tending to infinity x square divided by e raised to 3x is equal to limit x tending to infinity factorial 2 upon 3 square e raised to 3x is equal to 0 if finite quantity, or mod x square is equal to x square is less than e raised to 3x for all x greater than equal to 0. Hence, x square is of exponential order 3. The function x raised to n is of exponential order gamma. Gamma is greater than 0. N is element of natural numbers. Here, limit x tending to infinity x raised to n e raised to minus gamma x is equal to limit x tending to infinity x raised to n upon e raised to power gamma x is equal to limit x tending to infinity factorial n upon gamma raised to power n e raised to gamma x is equal to 0. Hence, x raised to n is of exponential order gamma. Another example, the function e raised to power x cube is not of exponential order, since limit x tending to infinity e raised to power x cube e raised to minus gamma x is equal to limit x tending to infinity e raised to power x cube divided by e raised to power gamma x is equal to infinity for all gamma. Hence, we cannot find a real number m greater than 0 such that e raised to power x cube is less than m e raised to power gamma x. Therefore, e raised to power x cube is not of exponential order. Existence conditions for Laplace transform. Theorem, statement: if fx is sectionally continuous in every finite interval, 0 is less than equal to x, is less than equal to x0, and is of exponential order gamma as x tends to infinity, then Laplace transform of fx p exists for p greater than gamma. Proof: let x0 be greater than 0, then Laplace transform of fx is defined as equal to integral 0 to infinity e raised to minus px fx dx. This is equal to integral 0 to x0 e raised to minus px fx dx plus integral x0 to infinity e raised to minus px fx dx. Since fx is sectionally continuous in 0 is less than equal to x, is less than equal to x0, the first integral in above equation exists. Again, fx is of exponential order gamma. When x tends to infinity, we have limit x tending to infinity e raised to minus gamma x, fx is finite. That is, for a given number x0, there exists a positive real number m such that mod of e raised to minus gamma x fx is less than m for all x greater than equal to x0, or fx is mod fx is less than m e raised to gamma x for all x greater than equal to x0. Now, modulus of integral x0 to infinity e raised to minus px fx dx is less than equal to integral x0 to infinity e raised to minus px mod fx dx. Now, mod of integral x0 to infinity e raised to minus px fx dx is less than equal to integral x 0 to infinity e raised to minus px mod of fx dx. This is less than integral x 0 to infinity e raised to minus px m e raised to gamma x dx. This is equal to m integral x 0 to infinity e raised to minus p minus gamma x dx is equal to m e raised to minus p minus gamma x 0 divided by p minus gamma when p is greater than gamma. Thus, mod of integral x 0 to infinity e raised to minus p x fx dx is less than m e raised to minus p minus gamma x 0 divided by p minus gamma if p is greater than gamma. Obviously, m e raised to minus p minus gamma x 0 divided by p minus gamma can be made as small as we please by choosing x 0 sufficiently large for p greater than gamma. Hence, integral x 0 to infinity e raised to minus px fx dx exists for all p greater than gamma. Therefore, Laplace transform of fx p exists for all p greater than gamma. Remarks: the conditions given in theorem 1.1 are sufficient for existence of Laplace transform of fx p but are not necessary conditions. For example, Laplace transform of x raised to n p exists for minus 1 is less than n is less than 0 even through x raised to power n tends to infinity as x tends to 0. For minus 1 is less than n less than 0, that is x raised to n is not sectionally continuous in every finite interval for the range x greater than equal to 0. Laplace transform of e raised to